I gotta say, all around, you're killing it. You know we're big fans here, but you got the book, Modern Romance, came out, went right to the bestseller list. Yep. That's giant. You're one of the biggest stand-ups working right now. And now you have this new show, Master of None. Mm-hmm. And this is, it's on Netflix.
Yes.
And now, why Netflix? You decided not to go with a network. You went right to Netflix.
Netflix, you know, we went to them, and they were just so supportive, and they were immediately on board, and they were like, we want to do 10 episodes, and I'd done my stand-up specials with them, and, yeah, it just seemed like a good fit for this project.
I mean, it's fantastic, and you got a crazy, awesome cast in there.
Mm-hmm.
Eric Wareheim, who was from Tim and Eric, if you know
yes.
that guy, is your best friend in the show. I love that dude.
Yeah, Eric plays my token white friend.
Yeah.
We kind of flipped it. It's usually like a few white people and then like one Asian guy, and they never see any other Asian people.
Yeah.
This is like, it's the reverse. Eric is my token white friend, and we gave him a stereotypical white role. He's a fully rounded character. So.
He's a fully rounded character. But Todd Barry is great in this.
Todd's great in it, yeah.
God, he's funny. John Benjamin. Claire Danes makes a cameo in it.
Yeah, she's really funny. And Noah Emmerich from The Americans, he's great. Yeah.
You're getting crazy good reviews on it. And you're directing it as well?
Yeah, I directed two episodes. Yeah, it was really fun, yeah.
How cool is that? You just get to do it, and it just came out perfect and fun.
Yeah, I'm really happy with it. I think people will dig it, yeah.
I want to show your parents in the show are your real-life parents.
My real parents played my parents, yeah.
How did you talk them into doing it, first of all?
Well, you know what happened is I wanted those characters to feel real, because sometimes when you see immigrant parents on TV and film, they're very broad, and they're just vehicles for these kind of hacky ethnic jokes where the dad will be like, oh, God, there's a tandoori chicken in my pocket. It's like, well, that's not really what happens. I've been around a lot of Indian people. That doesn't happen too often.
No, not too often. But when it does, it's funny. Yeah,
yeah,
but it's
so
rare. It's rare, though.
So I wanted it to feel real, like my parents. So I wrote the characters kind of based on my parents. And whenever we auditioned people, like we auditioned some actors to play my dad, the guy would come in and I'd read the scene and I'd be like, but dad, blah, blah, blah. And the guy would be like, but son, blah, 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 blah. And then at the end of the audition, he would go, thanks so much. It was really fun reading. I was like, what? That's your voice? Like, it felt like you were making fun of my dad. This guy, I'm not casting him. So.
Yeah. So then mom and dad come in.
And then I asked my parents to do it, and my dad and mom agreed, and they were fantastic, and you know, I've seen, like, reviews where they're, like, singling out my dad, like, oh, my God, Shaquille Ansari steals the show. I'm like, oh, my God, this is not...
Oh, no!
This is not what I wanted to happen
Created
at all.
Created a monster, yeah.
Yeah, he's already, like, calling me, he's like, oh, we gotta find the next project for me, and... I was like, what do you want to do? And he's like, well, doing the show is too much work. What about something shorter, like a commercial?
Do you have tandoori chicken?
Yeah.
There's a tandoori chicken in my pocket. Commercials. Yeah.
Well, I asked him. I was like, well, what would you want to do a commercial for? He was like, anything.
So he'll do anything.
He'll do any commercial. He doesn't care. So if anyone is interested in my dad.
In your dad, yeah.